Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to another video. And today we're gonna be talking about something really, really cool. I wanted this to be as part of like a apps that I can't live without series. And I'm starting off with probably the most important one. And as businesses grow through different phases, growth, refinement, you know, you iterate, you try to see where you can save costs, maybe you swap things out. And the one thing that I've noticed that I've never swapped out is my shared inbox called Missive. And what Missive does is it allows me to aggregate all the messages in and out from my company into one specific place. Sorry, companies. So you can have multiple different companies as well as my like personal social media all in one place. It means I get full visibility on what's happening, if things are getting replied to, if things need assistance, or I need to step in and look at something. It's all available in one place. I absolutely love it. I haven't found a reason to ever leave. I was using Front App previously, and I can definitely say that Missive is better. And this isn't sponsored by them, by the way. This is just genuinely a very, very useful thing that I think every business should be utilizing. And when I see this is not being utilized in businesses, I kind of like die a bit on the inside because, you know, of how much efficiency you're missing out on. So anyway, let me show you the website. It is not the fanciest. They've not got a boatloads of funding and investors and seed rounds and things like that. They actually are just like a bunch of developers that have decided to build this thing. So it's not like the classic usual, like, you know, start an app and then get like loads of investor money and then you're sort of led by what the investors want rather than like what the customers want. So it's very customer driven. I mean, I've emailed them and been like, you know, this is broken, and they actually fix it, you know, within a couple of days, you know, within the next release at least. And yeah, so you can see all these things. We're going to cover some of them in actual detail in a moment. So let's jump in and have a look at that. All right, so this is what it looks like. I've got dark mode on for it. And let me start off here in the top left is going to be all of your like personal inboxes. And your personal inboxes are just like you would have in Outlook. You can connect all different types of inboxes, like, you know, SMTP, Google, all of those things, IMAP, I mean. But additionally, you can connect Instagram, and you can also connect Facebook Messenger. You could have a Twilio number. You could have a whole bunch of different personal inboxes, and that would just be for you to like reply to, to read. But you can also tag people, and then you can like bring it into the organization, which I really, really love as well. Then you have just your like central, you know, you can check your messages, your composer and your, you know, where you can actually read the specific message. And then you have like different apps you can open up on the side, calendar, to-do lists, integrations. We'll get there in a bit. I'm on my laptop at the moment traveling, so it's not ideal to be on a, you know, it looks a hell of a lot better at home on my like 4K monitor. And I have sized things a little bit differently to just to make it good for the screenshots. And yeah, so that's just something, it doesn't look as compact when I'm like actually using it, because you can close this, then it splits it, makes it a little bit nicer. And you can also shrink that and shrink this a bit, then you have a nice big composer, which I like. Okay, so you connect your personal inboxes. I think you have a limit of 10 or 15, but per organization, you can add on more. Then next thing is the all inboxes. So as you can see, I've got quite a few different channels, messaging channels coming in. And again, importantly, I have different Instagrams, different Facebook messengers, emails, phone numbers. You can connect WhatsApp, which I'm in the process of doing now. It's super simple. I just haven't gotten around to it or had the best use case for it, but you can connect it in. You can actually monitor it. You can search messages, and it's not like all on like someone's phone. That's where you can see all of your messages, but that's just in the back end. It gets a little bit more organized here in where you're supposed to look is the team inboxes. You can take five of those channels that I just showed you. You can put it into like international, and then these emails are linked to domestic, and then these are going to be linked to your socials, and you can divide it up and then add different team members to different inboxes. Very, 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 very helpful. So that's like when the main bulk of the organization, and this is when everything starts to come together. You can monitor 10 different email addresses in one place and then just see if it's all getting replied to and make sure that you're not missing quotes and, you know, tender requests and things that are coming back into some arbitrary email that someone else was using way back when. You get tags and you get some other features down the side, super useful. All right, moving on. Inbox types, touched on this a bit, but yeah, I use IMAP a lot. It's super helpful to now have one IMAP connection to the server. Previously, I had, for instance, like six people with Outlook, and then you would go and connect each computer to that server. So now you have six connections to that server, and the servers can't handle that really. So when you search, it's searching, you know, that server, but then at the same time, this person's doing email, so it's kind of, you can miss things. And instead, with Missive, you connect Missive to the server, and then Missive, you know, spreads all the emails out to everybody really nicely. You can connect Google Workspace, SMS, WhatsApp, we've covered these. Air call and Dialpad, I think, would be really cool to see in action, but I haven't had a chance to play around with those just yet. Right, when it comes now to actually looking at an email and seeing like the whole, you know, beauty of this is the fact that you can obviously just tag people right on the email. You don't need a forward and CC and BCC, and then you have like forward, 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 re. That just like, and for someone who doesn't like the, you know, who likes organizations, maybe a bit OCD, this is just so nice. You know, you can bring in whoever you want on the message. Why is this, you know, how can we complete this? You know, when is this, you know, can we postpone this? You know, can we action this? Follow up messages, it's really, really helpful. Bring in multiple teams, different organizations can come in and oversee this. And yeah, that's it. This is where the beauty happens. And then you have that whole discussion in one place, and then someone replies to the email at the end of the day, and everyone can see the reply, and we can assign and add people to that conversation. So fantastic. If you don't have an email that's come in, you can also just do like a discussion. And that means you can just create like a chat. And what's nice about this is you start to move things from like WhatsApp group chats and Slack channels closer to sort of the source of truth, which is, you know, just one place. So for me, if I can run all of my organizations combined, and I don't need to have all these other different apps plugging in. Maybe when you factor that in later, when we talk about the costing as well, something really, I don't know, this was in front as well, but it's, you know, it wasn't in like Gmail, maybe it is now. Anyway, snoozers, I use that extensively. I like to clear my inbox, but if I can't clear it, I snooze it. Counts as clearing it in my mind. But yeah, so you have a variety of snoozers. You can just use the shortcuts, keyboard shortcuts, snooze the email, pops up next week, you can deal with it then. And same goes if it's a message or Instagram or something like that. Then you have a calendar integration, love this as well. I've got it connected with Zoom. I can create a meeting, it adds a Zoom link, and then, you know, I can obviously invite. It kind of works exactly like Google Calendar. It is synced with Google Calendar as well. You can sync with a bunch of other calendars, if I'm not mistaken. Composer, straightforward. Maybe there's like fancier composers, but does everything that I need it to do. You select the email that you want it to come from, create a, you know, subject, who it's going to. And this can be any of your shared inboxes that you have access to. And then you can obviously, there is some like AI things here you can play around with. They have kind of come out and said they're not gonna be like an AI first company. Fair, I think they're gonna go the route of more like integrating a bit more to-do lists. See, they've got a to-do list feature and they're gonna sort of bring that in, allow people to assign it, which I kind of like. I think that is where a lot of their users are, you know, needing something, and to action within an email is very nice. Or you can use the ClickUp integration, like here, create a new task or link a task. Moving on, I've discussed before, like there's multiple organizations with multiple users. So you can have, I think, unlimited organizations probably, but you obviously, you get a free plan. Well, you used to get a free plan, I'm not too sure, foggy at the moment, but yeah, you can have organizations and you add organizations, and when you add users to the organizations, that's when they start charging you per user, and you can have all the organization settings and so on and so forth. Integrations, I really like this. Shopify, I've tried the video chat, pretty cool. OpenAI, Make obviously is a big one that I've spoken a lot about on this channel. That's quite cool. Then Dropbox, ClickUp, I use quite a bit. I used to use Asana, would love to use AirCall. I'm pretty sure GitHub's pretty cool, and Google Drive. So anyway, you can connect those in and it becomes like part of your email system. You get some analytics. It's kind of paywalled, so you have to go, I think you gotta be on like the really high package to get access to this. I think I'm on the medium, so I get just like a dashboard. It's not enough to make it worth you know, oh, he had this cool analytics board. For me personally, maybe if I was running like a center where I had to like, you know, churn out support tickets, possibly that would be more useful. I could at least get some KPIs to deliver to clients. But for me, you know, I would probably want to rather see like user and team performance rather, but that's on like the high plan, I believe. You get a sick app with Missive. I use that all the time. Probably shouldn't to like check my mails. Maybe replying, I don't do as much on the mobile app anymore, probably because I don't reply to like hundreds of emails all the time. But I have in the past, I have at the airport, it's great, it works, and yeah, it's really, really slick. Now, the pricing, it did just recently go up, so to be fair, and it's probably gonna stay this way for like the next 2-3 years. And they've got the yearly plan, so that you save a bit if you get the yearly. You know, if you've got 5 users on one organization, then it's like, adds up kind of quickly per month, especially if you're on the business. And the cheaper plans aren't that great because it limits your like search history to like I think 30 or 50 days. So the starter's not really that great. It would be for a very, very small business. And well, actually no, I think there's, maybe I can't see the free plan. The free plan limits your thing, and then the starter lets you have like up to 6 months, up to 5 users. You can search as far back as you need, and you can get past this 5 user limit. And yeah, so pretty pricey. My only gripe is that if you have users in both organizations as a small business, that's obviously a case. And like for me, I'm, you know, as the owner, you need to be in every organization. So that's, you know, just $100 just for me to have access to my different organizations. Whereas I feel like they're not really using more server power or things like that. So, you know, you could probably comp that. Would be cool, guys. That's pretty much my only gripe. And other than that, yeah, I wouldn't trade it at the moment. I haven't found any competitors that even get close. If you're looking at trying it, at least just get the free trial, plug in a couple inboxes, add 2 users, tag your mate, and just reply, and then just see the beauty of it. It works really well. You can even use it in conjunction with your current setup for a while. So if you wanna do like a parallel conversion, I did that. Let everyone run on Outlook, and I sort of just connected all the IMAPs in the meantime, let enough like, you know, test, and then sort of like add 1 staff, let them get familiar, make sure that they're comfortable with it, and then add all the rest, and then you can like just eliminate all that like Outlook nonsense where you have to connect different accounts and people's out, you know, if their software needs to be updated or installed. This is just way, way, way better. All in all, highly recommend it. I think it's pivotal to any business. And yeah, I'm Andy. I do business tips and tricks to help you grow your business. If you like this video, please leave a thumbs up and subscribe, and I'll check you guys in another one.